Celtic high crosses are among the most important monuments to survive from Ireland's golden age of saints and scholars. Their figure carvings illustrate various Old Testament and New Testament Bible stories like a film strip, with each of their individual panels representing different Bible accounts. Ancient Celtic crosses can be seen throughout Ireland's countryside and cemeteries. The Celtic high crosses were probably the most important achievement in the entire history of Irish sculpture. Generally, sculpted from sandstone and reaching a height of 20 feet, Celtic crosses are characterized by the circle connecting the four arms of a standard cross. Others will point out that the Celtic cross was also known as a sun cross or a sun wheel, and was a symbol of Odin, the Norse god. The circle in the Celtic cross is now widely known to represent the sun. Modern interpretations view the circular portion as a symbol of eternal life and God's infinite love. Glendalough combines extensive monastic ruins with a magnificent setting in the Wicklow Mountains. The beauty and tranquility of the lake and the glacial carved valley probably appealed to St. Kevin, a monk who founded the monastic site near the lower lake in the 6th century. Most of the buildings that survive today date from the 10th through the 12th centuries, which include two high crosses. The Drumcliffe High Cross is one of the finest examples left in Ireland. The carvings on the cross represent biblical scenes including Adam and Eve, Daniel in the lion's den, the crucifixion, and Christ in majesty on the day of judgment. The carvings on the cross were originally painted in bright colors and were a visual aid for teaching the Christian faith to pilgrims who would have gathered round to be told the stories depicted on them. The Celtic cross has become a popular symbol to the Irish, and its unique history and design is now popular around the world. They can be seen in any form, from necklaces to tattoos. They are found in private gardens and cemeteries in both the United States and Ireland. And both the Gaelic Athletic Association and the Northern Ireland national football team use versions of the Celtic cross in their logos and advertising. Ireland's Celtic high crosses have certainly passed the test of time.